take a deeper look into some of the modding stuff for War in the Pacific. I'm currently preparing a playthrough and experimenting a lot, and I want to find the right playthrough for me. Still not decide if I want to start with Japan or with the US. I don't have that much time because A, I'm for real life stuff, and B, because I have so many war games I want to play, and so I'm always cautious when committing to a game, especially of that size. And yeah, let me show what some stuff I found out. Let's start with the AI files. You know, the in-game AI is basically built into the engine, and that's fine. I don't think you can modify it. However, there are AI scripts which can come with a scenario which help the AI to operate on an operational level. You know, to commit amphibious landings, whatever. These are basically scripts like a movie script, which tell the AI do this, do that, or if X happens, do Y. You know, if Americans invade, whatever, react with this solution. So it's an operational level to help the AI. And if you download and purchase War of the Pacific, War in the Pacific, it comes with already good AI. For new players, it should be fine if you keep some stuff in mind, like keeping the difficulty on hard, because otherwise the AI might have trouble to supply some of his units. And then you can choose either start with the historical scenario, which is the easiest one, because but the most historical one. However, you play against an AI which of course can't be that good like the real humans, like real humans or like real commanders back then. However, you as early player, you have the, I don't know, the scenario 2 cho option or the Iron Man option, which makes it always a step harder. So yeah, and about the AI, however, there was some sort of unofficial update by people that are working for a long time on the game, and there's this guy, he does a lot of AI scripts updating, and he released update. You can find this thread in the War in the Pacific Matrix forums and tech support patch 07. Yeah, I get it. That's the title of the thread. And I think it's a bit complicated how the files are presented, especially you need to download them, rename them to executables, and then, oh god damn it, you want to install them, they auto-locate your install folder, but if you extract some of them or all of them, extract into the main root, which isn't the intended location for these files, and you end up with yeah, some sort of bullshit. I was thinking about simply to download all of them, extracted them manually to my desktop. Sometimes this installer stuff makes it even more complicated. And yeah, simply upload it to my Dropbox or something. I guess it's because the forms have some file size limitation, but you need to locate them for every single scenario and download them. And this update also adds some new ones. I can't tell you much about most of them, but one interesting is scenario 17, Iron Man for a Japanese human player. I think in the normal version, if you play the release version, even with beta patch and whatever, there is no higher difficulty for Japan players. And a lot of Japan players report that the Ellie's AI isn't that challenging, even on the first playthrough. So this one would basically give you an harder AI. Yeah, like I said, you either choose one of the scenarios. For example, one is the standard, two is this with a bit stronger Japanese, and 10 is the Iron Man Japanese, so a little bit more harder. And there are still, even if you research on the forums, there's even more of them. Iron Man is basically tier one. There's tier two, tier three. You know, there are people who play this game for several years. They're looking for a new challenge. And the main challenge is provided by giving the enemy more assets, or better assets, better trained pilots, more experienced soldiers, whatever. That's fine. That's basically in every computer game, you know, difficulty by quantity or by opposition. Because AI technology, current AI technology isn't, at least for in video games, isn't that far that it can be, especially for games like this that are so complex. The AI also will be struggling. However, I'm talking here about really stuff for ex veterans and whatever. Guys like us, you know, who play this first time or whatever, I guess you will get blasted away on this tier two, tier three or whatever. Iron Man is, I guess, already enough. Most people start the game on scenario one, so this historical setup, in order to learn it. And yeah, however, you can either download one of them, choose one of them, and then I will show it you. You download it, and yeah, I guess the form prevents. Yeah, you download it, you get this file. No, you can't extract it. You then need to rename it. Yeah, I know it's complicated, but that's it. You need to rename it to exe, and then you need to execute it. It will locate your folder, like I said, but it doesn't install in the correct subfolder. So it's really, yeah, a bit str not well designed. I will do it on the desktop. It also doesn't have the option to create a new folder. That's, I think, the first time I see an installer that is not able to do this. Because if I extract now on the desktop, it will plaster my desktop with 1 million files. So I need to create a new folder, so let's hope it will find it. Yeah, it found it. I do it this way, and then you extract it simply, and then you get the files here, and you should simply upload the folder, period. Then the new stuff is uploaded in this fashion. But yeah, really complicated and also somewhat misleading, because you think, oh, he locates my game folder, and a lot of people think they installed their AI, they didn't. And I can perfectly understand why they think they installed their AI correctly. Then you get this folder, and what was it for a scenario? I can see it here on the number. It's scenario 11. 11 was, yeah, Marianas. Not sure, never played it. But yeah, and then you go to your War in the Pacifics form scenario, and there you can throw in the files. Like I said, some of the. Yeah, 11 is already included in the game, it seems. And then you can simply take them and copy them over and overwrite. And you can do it basically for everyone. You don't need to do this, but they should be fine. These 2012 AI files, they are, it seems, stable, tested, and they provide a good base for a lot of scenarios, even for a lot of modded scenarios. It seems that after this AI update, the paths get get excluded because there are some guys who worked on the extended map, there are some guys who worked on specific new bases in their databases. It looks like there are a lot of different databases then circulating around. But this is basically the base. You know, back when this was released, everything was in, I don't know, one place. And yeah, however, you don't need to do it. Games AI should also be fine, and especially for a new player, it's also questionable if you will notice any differences. And that's about the AI. Next, I found this page here also on the mods forum. It provides a graphics mod. Download is here. And I will test it out now. It comes in a file. Delete it. Looks like I deleted it. No, here. It's this here I need and this here. And it comes in this file, you can unpack it, and yeah, if you see my first video, you know it. There is this art folder, there's basically most of the graphics in it. And this game completely overhauls your visuals. However, it comes also with your own map, so and with counters and symbols. So keep this in mind. If you're already running a custom map, you might want to delete the map files if you don't like the map style the mod comes. It looks like the stock map, but darker, I guess, more in a more sepia way. This mod has some vintage look to it. I like it. However, if you don't want a map, delete the files or overwrite with your map. I have already installed it to my, so I don't need this. And sure, if you other don't like other things, you know, most of these mods are modular, like in most games. If you don't like, I don't know, this symbol is here, delete it and they're gone. You should get the idea. I mean, not rocket science here involved. So. And about the maps, I already presented it, I think, in a review video. There's this big map folder, I think I linked it. And back then I didn't knew about it, what is X and what is S. S stands for stock map or for the small map, which is in the game. But there was a mod, extended map mod, which extended the map and made it bigger, even bigger, so more. And with new bases and whatever, and it isn't compatible with the stock art files. So if you're using the big mob map mod, for example, in Da Babe, Big Babes, that's a popular scenario which is played by a lot. Use the X1 for extended. I currently running the stock map, so. And I like this one here, that's also seen a lot on YouTube videos. And this map is really one of the. I mean, the other one, the topographic one, I can showcase you in another mod. But I run the rainy one, the sunny is more brighter, the rainy, like you imagine, is. And there you have stock and extended versions. And I use this one here. Yeah, already installed. So, but if you simply copy over to your arts folders. And you're good to go. Okay, that's about maps. Next. And one thing I need to correct, but it's because people on the forums write, yeah, no, it doesn't work. And then you read it three, four times, you think, okay, it doesn't work. And then you find out later then that three pages le somebody responded that this is complete bullshit. So about the extended map and even the page itself, this DaBabe page, it somehow indicates that you shouldn't use it with the AI. However, the AI works pretty okay with the extended map, so it's not true that it isn't compatible. It can't use the new bases and some of the new hexes on the map, but from a strategic point of view, this isn't that important. But the rest of the AI will work. And so, if you want to play with an extended map, you can do with AI against AI, you can do, and yeah. Because there were people reporting it isn't working, but it is. Okay. Next, I will start a game and show you how to run this in true full screen, and at the same time, we will take a look at this mod here and to see how it looks like. And I will also use some tools like the tracker mod and the combat reporter. Yeah, first we will build a good executable with the CB tool, which is basically what the first thing you want to get. I already showed it in the video. And we will do a 1920. Wait. Yeah, that's full HD. Single CPU orders. A strange name, but it means that you're basically running multi-core. Only, I think the orders phase is single CPU, the rest is running on multi-orders. And that's what you want. You want for the processing, you want multi-CPU. You don't, it's not interesting for you what CPU mode you are in the orders, but yeah, strange naming conventions here. And I have a quad core, so from what I've read, it's recommended to get this here. It's recommended to get multi-audio, even if the tooltip mentions only to get it if the issues never had issues, but I see, so a recommendation. Windowed. Full screen is working with this, but I also noticed that if there are, at least for me, if there are windows in the background, you sometimes see stuff popping out, and so it looks like windowed is the way to go. Skip video, don't need the video, and of course better release, and then we will build the shortcut. It is here already, but if we delete it, you will see it will appear again if I press here. It's basically build a shortcut with this custom commands. Here, built into it, baked into it. That's it. I mean, we can also start this administrator. Ah, it's already done. And before that, I will launch a tool called WinXP. I will need it for setting true full screen. And I will launch a tool called Taskbar Eliminator. That's my current solution of getting true full screen, true borderless full screen with this tool, with this game. And let's go. You see, that's already the new menu art. Okay, we will stay in the menu and go to this here, Win Explorer, but first I will eliminate my taskbar. If you press once, it is still there. If you press twice, it's gone. I mean, this window mode is also okay, but yeah, it's can get full screen. First, let's load a game. And I will also show you that you can play this game quite fast. You don't need to stay 1 million. It's really quite fast. If you disable the combat summaries, combat animations, I mean, you can leave on the summaries. Every battle will generate a summary, but I will show you that you can also play without it if time is a constraint for you. And the combat animations, I like them. But sure, they take a lot of time. That's when you see this 2D art, the planes battling with each other. I like it really. Don't want this game gets a big immersion bonus by it. And I think when I will do a real true playthrough for myself, I will enable it and skip it with escape if I don't interested into it. And yeah, if I set this here to 0 and 0.1, it will really quickly get through the rounds. And that's for me then some of the new scenarios like the Japanese player Iron Man. And yeah. Okay, let's start the standard campaign. But I want to be the Japan player. Yeah, I don't like this here, it's a bit strange. And I think this switched. This means now Japan player, yeah, I think so. Because Alice is standard always. Japan player, human player. And here's AI. Email game, hot seat. Yeah. I mean, if you install this mod, you basically already know the main menu. But a player that first installs that, he might have issues to see this ghost stuff here, this indicator. Okay. Yeah, historic first turn, sure. So, scenario, let's start. Yeah, the Pacific full campaign, historical. Like I said, if I would start with Japanese, I'm not sure if I would start this or this here. This is basically the harder scenario when you play Japan. I like to play Japan, interested in Japanese culture, and it gives the US player a lot more assets, which helps it to operate. And you get only this scenario if you download this AI update I shown you, this scenario update, this unofficial patch 7. And the turn is now commencing. That's the first turn, Pearl Harbor attack, and look how long it will take. I mean, you basically can. The first turn on standard settings might take really long, but you will see how quickly he goes over it. If you set the delay to low and disable any interruptions, the game is really fast. However, you might now think, yeah, I'm losing the complete information. I don't know what is happening. There's a way to tell you, to filter that. I will show you. There's also good tools. I don't recommend to play this way, but if you perhaps same like me and have some time constraints about playing huge games like this, this definitely is a good setup. And that's it, he's now saving, I think. Oh, okay, now he's still doing stuff. Okay, now he's saving, that was it. That was turn one. That was the historical 7 December. And you see it was quite fast in comparison to standard settings, and I think it's completely fine. It's like in a big Civilizations game, a bit longer perhaps. But if you imagine that what the stuff that happened on the 7th, you know, with the surprise attack and everything. Okay, now we will fix our interface. As you can see, we have the bar and the lower interface is a bit hidden and we don't see it, but there's some a piece missing. Now we will use the tool called Win Explorer. You can download it for free. Press refresh. You will see all your active tasks. You select War in the Pacific, go to size and position. And I think left is set. It's basically, this allows you to align the window. And then we will use top. I think my setting was 30 something. Modify, yeah, 31. Yeah. However, you see there is, I mean, we could also do, there is some space. It's because CB calculates the header into the resolution. Perhaps we can remove it. Wait, no, there was, wasn't there? I think I'm missing something. Wasn't there a style? I think you can remove this upper stuff. This header here, this here, which would us give. However, you could also set a other resolution in CB, I guess. This is the small one, that's the 1080, perhaps set it to 1100 or something, not sure. But I think it's not that bad. You see this bar, you could also move it down. This here, 15 perhaps. Yeah, you see it's okay. But wasn't there, because I already used this tool also for command. Think there was something like this here. Windows fig frame minimize disabled. Forgot it. Didn't work. Isn't working. Perhaps because I launched it. Ah, I didn't launch Win Explorer as admin. Yeah, that's important. Otherwise, you might not be able to modify stuff which is launched in administrator because it doesn't get the right to do it. Doesn't work. Whatever. Yeah, looking to remove this here. There was a way to remove this. Whatever. This here is set it to 30 and perhaps modify the resolution in CB or 30. Everybody has different settings, but I'm running a usual 16:9 screen, you know, full HD. I'm just looking to get this rid of this here, but I will find a way, either by modifying the resolution in CB, you know, you could add here a bit so it gets bigger. I think this should work. I was also thinking, but sometimes this stuff doesn't work for specific tools, games. But that's fine. We now have almost true full screen. Next time when I start the next mod, I will add, I don't know, what is this, 20 pixels perhaps? Yeah, about. And look at this map. I think, or look at the complete graphics. I think that's one of the, at least map-based, one of the most beautiful map-based war games was completely modded. And yeah, let's check. Yeah, it's our submarines. This will also help you to tell if the windows are aligned correctly. Why it always has to be aligned to the top, because otherwise this will bug out. But in our case it's fine. And let's check out the new screens to see the buttons are also new. Yeah, I like the new style, it's more so, like I said, vintage. Looks really professional. Really good. Great mod. Great visual mod, I will keep it. Yeah, beautiful. Every window is new. Yeah, and this also looks more fresh. Yeah, great screens. I recommend really great art style. Yeah, perhaps this this screen here, but I think it's because it's so pixelated in the background, it makes it harder to recognize information. That's only the corner I have here, but it's not really not just not that you still can read it. Just notice it's somehow straining on the eyes a bit because it's so. You have these pixels here in the background from the smoke, together with the 1 million little fonts and information. It's a bit too much. Yeah, and the map you can get in different shades. I'm using the rainy shade. You can a different sunny shade and whatever. And yeah, beautiful. Yeah. There's also a new art style here, and like I said, I'm using a emblem mod. Can't go without it. Gives me really the historical vibes. This stuff like this here. Okay, yeah, I like it. I think I will keep it. Ah, okay, and the tools. Now I will show you two tools. One is pretty known. I think it's sometimes really difficult to set up, but first tool is the tracker. A lot of people use the tracker. There's a node map version, a track, and a normal version. The node map version, because the normal tracker, it sometimes fails to load. Even for me, it failed to load. I modified some of the settings. I don't know. It's it's a bat datei file, and you can modify it. I think by making this numbers greater, it often works. So simply don't load the map. I don't see that much utility in this map. We will load normal first. And yeah, let's save the game in 5, because the tracker goes after save games. No, that can't be. I think he loaded the game before I was able to save, because I set my tool to load from the game directory. Before you can use the tool. God damn it! I need to get a bit rid of here of the stuff here. And this. I think we already shown you everything here. We don't need this anymore. We don't need this. CB we might need. We don't need this here. And this is the best track. This track is so good. This soundtrack. I need to make it louder. First, you want to modify this file here. and set everything. New game directory. Are you playing against AI or human? Which site you are playing are currently set to Japan? Which save is loaded? Do you want load saves that you throw in manually here, or do you want to load saves from your game directory? Mine is set to the game directory. Okay. And turn cycles. Set this if you use one or two. If you use four turn cycles, it looks like it's not supported. I don't know, man, what is going on with this? I'm not... December 8th, a full campaign, that's not true. God damn it, this tool is so annoying sometimes to me. Sometimes it's working, sometimes it's not working. It stops working. God damn it. Okay, let's find out what's the problem here. I'm saving in slot 5, yes. Let's override it. Okay, perhaps it was loading correctly. I was just... Because I tested a campaign which is called ISO December 8th campaign. And it's exactly the title here, December 8th, the full campaign. And yeah, let's see if it's working. Looks like it's working. Yeah, really good track. It's we can advance one turn and see if it's then I will do nothing and simply advance. And you can now see that it will run quickly advancing turns. What happened to my window? God damn it. Never had this. It's a show effect. Okay, now see if this tool will load the next turn and if the strange name will change here. What is going on with this goddamn tool? I mean, it's definitely not. I think that's the reason why I see only people using manual over putting manual. It looks like there's something not working with this. Where's my games folder? I will now test it if manually. Save. That's our save. Ah, we need to say. Ah, no, no. Oh, perhaps I'm. Yeah. So I already see it. Somebody will come. You stop bashing the tool. You of course need first to save, otherwise, yeah. And then it should work. Okay. And that now you return. Okay, now it's working. Hey, even without errors. Finally. And now it's turn 3 loaded, okay, everything is fine and you can check all your stuff. And what is interesting is I was thinking when I modify stuff, for example I do something, I don't know, let's set up base, different, or industry. Let's say I set this to no. Let's set everything to turn off everything and then I save the game again. Can I reload in order to get the updated information? Yeah, already loaded, but I've changed stuff. Shouldn't that be a thing? I guess not. Okay, whatever. Yeah, this tool is really informative. You see, you can get a lot of information. You get a map, but not sure what it's good for. Because you don't see units on it. You see base is okay. But I mean you could also simply open a PDF file or something. So if the game is giving you starting troubles, start simply with no map because this function isn't dead. You can't set anything here. I mean you can set search arcs, okay. Perhaps some of you need this. Ship movement. Don't see any ship movement here. Or enemy subs. I mean, Pearl Harbor should. No. Yeah, whatever. If you have trouble, start without the map. Okay, looks like it's not working. Yeah, the Japanese are first, okay. Okay, and there's another tool. Called Combat Reporter. And there's a strange thing, I think you need to launch Combat Reporter after the tracker. Not sure if both run together, but you see it detects This is December 10, December 9. Guess I'm still having old reports in the. Yeah, I get it, I get it. You need to set the preferences and then you set your date in order to prevent exactly this. Today is the 13th. So we will set this to 13th and he will ignore my old reports. And player Japanese, save. Okay, why are you not locating the new folder? The new one. Perhaps I need to set the. Yeah. That's because of the clock. I don't know. 10 a.m. That's okay. He now located reports. These are the most recent ones of this game here. You can close this windows. And then, for example, last round was December 8th. Currently, it's December 9th. And you can check. And this tool is really great. You can maximize it, but you can also keep it in some fashion like this. See, it even works like this really good. You can check it here, really command center like. And here you have your ops report, but everything nicely put together. And if you press on it, it even shows you on the map most times where this stuff is happening. And there you also have your combat reports for air, for ground. And I think this gives you a quick overview what is going on. I know people who play this by completely turning off the in-game combat and simply going after this because you can also filter the information you need. Yeah, sometimes you have this, not sure why, but. Kotabaru, okay. Yeah, they are landing here. Okay, I will advance one turn because I want to know if this tool stops running because the combat reporter is running. But I think when I launch first the combat reporter and then launch this tracker tool, it won't work. It will say something is already in use. But vice versa, it's possible. I can't give you confirmation, perhaps it's also possible, but it was some anomaly. But if you plan to use both tools and have the same issues like me, try out to launch the tracker first. What the hell? Why do I have four windows? What is this here? I don't think I need this. I also don't need this. And I also notice when the game isn't in focus, I think it stops. Let's see. Yeah, it stops displaying or it stops also processing. Let's see what happens if we press here, if the game jumps. No, it looks like it stops. You know, some games have this attribute that they stop processing when it's not focused. At least I think it's can't tell for sure. Sometimes this can be prevented by the option always on top. But it looks like it is processing us in the background, so forget it. I'm not sure. Okay, let's see if the tracker manages to load a new round without failing. Yeah, super. What the hell? Looks fine. Reports, alerts are coming in. Some base got captured. I mean, this also is basically a combat reporter built in to some extent. You also have Intel, you see. Yeah, this is... So, this tracker also does a lot what Combat Reporter does, but... I think both tools have some... Ah, that's our submarines, okay. Midget, I think SSX are midget submarines. They weren't that successful in Pearl Harbor, so like here also it looks like most of them got sunk without doing anything. However, if you the combat reporter is also working, and yeah, the only stuff that is first time I'm experiencing this is that this goddamn bar is always returning. Not sure why this is. I guess perhaps because it's room. But we will now test the other mod out, and I will modify, I don't know, add 20 pixels or something to see if this changes anything. Okay, next I installed a mod called HS. Looks like a mod that is already around for a long time, and some of these features, even from what I've read, found its way into the main game, into the Admiral's Edition. You know, this game has a long history. It's not, so there were different editions. Yeah, let's build a new shortcut for it. Yeah, there's even a setting for it. If you have multiple installs, press this. I said 40 pixels approx. Perhaps it's so. Let's see if this will fix the missing pixels. Is it working? Not really. How the hell did... I think I changed something else. You know what? I would be even fine with the taskbar. I mean, it's not that bad to have a taskbar in. So let's get rid of the taskbar eliminator. You know, especially if you have to use so much tools, I think a taskbar is still more convenient than alt tabbing. Because I don't know how to get rid of this empty space there, and I'm really not that. Okay, let's quit it quickly. We launch it and reset the window. And we are now in this RHA mod, and you already seen there are some new screens and which tell you that the mod is installed. It also comes with an own map. I overwritten the map with the topographic map this time. RHS uses the extended map, and where's the desktop? Wait, show you on the desktop. You get this folder here, you can find it in the mods subform of Matrix. And I recommend you, for big mods like this, simply make a copy and paste of your install folder, so you have several install folders, like I did. I made a copy of my folder and called it RHS. Warner Pacific isn't that big of a game. It's from its file size, not from its game size. Then you go to installers, installer setup files, you launch this, install it, and if you want to use a map mod, you will use the xmaps. I'm using topographic dot and hexless. Dot is modifying the hex, like H files, and the hexless is modifying the N files, like no hex. Yeah, I think it's complicated, you know, but looks like there are 1 million choices, and choices are good, but first time if you see the folder you think, what the hell. because the game has two map modes, and this is for the no hex map mode, and this you can choose either you want to have hexes on the water. See the little hexes. Yeah, that's the overview map. Get this open, you see the hexes on the map. But you could also use a dot map, which then looks this. I'm using the dot map currently, I think it's better. So looks more military style. And there's even a... Yeah, whatever, there are choices, you can check it out for yourself. I've installed the topographic extended map. X looks like the full stock map of the topographic map is missing. There's only this upgrade, but it isn't enough. The files in this are not complete. Yeah, but this is a bit topo up. Update only, and simply get these files here into this folder. This makes more sense for me, because these aren't complete. 10 times better. Now this map, topo map, update only, incomplete. Yeah, that's basically the two main folders are these here. And you see there's only X, there's no stock map of this. People are looking for it. I'm currently looking also for the stock map. But I'm fine with the Yamamoto map. It's already installed. Okay. And here you can set the map style, but I think you can also set it in-game. You could basically run two different maps, I think. Yeah, you could run two different maps. Not sure if there are some issues with it. With hex and without hex. I think there is an issue. There could be an issue, at least a visual issue. Ah, no. Yeah, we can't do this. I'm running a mod. Okay, about the mod. I think when you're playing this mod, you want to ignore the standard scenarios here. But if you scroll down, you get the RHS scenarios. And that's an RHS, to give you an overview of what this mod is about. It's a big project and it aims to make it more accurate, historical as well. And it also gives you some choices like different outcomes of the naval treaties, you know, the Washington Treaty and whatever, where the nations decided which ships they are allowed to build and how much tonnage they are allowed to build, whatever. And this mod also assumes some plausible historical outcomes of this treaties, which might end up with new ships. You know, there were some historical ships that were scrapped because of this treaty, or which were rebuilt, modified, reconfigured. And yeah, it's a lot of interesting what-if scenarios. There's also a scenario where Russia is not in war, but is active. You can do stuff with them and whatever. And total war option, I think this is basically where the treaty was going really out of hand or something, not sure. You can read it on this if you Google them. I think it's a bit difficult to find a proper documentation. I've found a thread where all, or even in the mod, in the documentation folder, I found something which explained it. It's sometimes really difficult to find, because I think if you download a mod, it should be first information, what is this mod about? And not, I don't know, somewhere buried into in thousands of files. And however, it's like I gave you an overview, and if you play against the AI, this is pretty good, as it already mentions AI oriented. But I'm not sure if you can play this against only the Japanese AI, or if you can also play this against the Elliot AI. It's sometimes difficult to tell. I mean, we can test it if it will work. Yeah, interesting is it has quite bigger loading time. I'm running full screen or what? Why is it on full screen? Did I forget to set it correctly? Looks like yes, it has some cool new sounds. At least I think this, yeah, this must be new sounds. Yeah, I would really like if somebody would remove this. This summing bomb sound that's sometimes really annoying if you hear it 1 million times. Make it more decent, perhaps I will make it myself. And what you see is now the topographic map. These bombs. Goddamn bombs. I mean, now it's in full screen, or isn't it? Is it because the taskbar is so fat? I think there was a setting that you can make your taskbar slimmer. What was the setting for it? This here. But it looks like now it's... Let's see if what happens if we remove the taskbar. It's almost, what the hell is this? Why is the... No, it's full... What is going on? God damn. What the hell? Why is it... What the hell? Okay, now it's what we already know. That is basically like beforehand. You always have this little gap here, which is fine. I think if you use a little The little taskbar. This here. And if the Windows then stops to, why is it? I used the tool before I prepared everything and it wasn't doing this. Okay, I think this is fine. This is really the best I can get out of this. Use a small taskbar. I think it is nothing is hidden, because there is a little bit hidden from there, but it isn't containing information. Yeah, this is okay. I like it. You can still go quickly into the internet, browse stuff. And one great thing about, yeah, we don't need two CBs. Okay. About the combat reporter is you can also keep it on the. No, it was the it wasn't the combat reporter. It was the. The tracker can be kept on. On always on top, so you can. Yeah, I already showed it, I think. Yeah, this is also a great map. More realistic, it's more. Looks a bit like Command. And let's check the OOBs. I think this mod adds new ships. But for the AI version, it's basically a light version. There's some stuff kept out because the AI can't use it. Yeah, this looks definitely new. Some cargo ships, smaller cargo ships were added, but I guess historical. Could imagine this looks new with the name never seen beforehand. A lot of the smaller vessels were added. Let's see if the patrol boats are in. What is the LCE? What is this? Not sure what an LCE is. Okay. Yeah, the patrol boats. Where's my taskbar? What the hell is happening with this tool? Why is it going in full screen? My taskbar is gone. Why is it now in full screen? I don't get it. It's really strange. I mean, it's now in perfect, but yeah, I don't know what I did, but it's not working. Like I did before recording the video. And yeah, you can press one of this, and if the ship art is aligned, it's working. Otherwise, you would have some graphical distortion here. Yeah, let's see what new ships I might. But I'm not good at it. I can't tell which ships are new, and I think there are new carriers. This is definitely a historical one. Historical one. Okay. Yeah, whatever. That's a mod. I should dig more into it so I could present you something. There's a page, where was it, where the scenarios are presented in a good f but it's also perhaps you can find it together. I want my taskbar back. You know, for 10 minutes we tried to get rid of to get our full screen. Now I have full screen. Now I would need my taskbar to start my Internet Explorer, and it's gone. Really crazy. Yeah, whatever. Check it out for yourself. But how this happened, I'm not sure. Yeah, that's a page, but these files, they are also in the mod. They are in the mod. So I didn't need to download them. In the Mediterranean. Wow, complete new theater of area of operations or what? Ah, that's the old game. I'm in the old form. Was already wondering why there's nothing new. Yeah, whatever. One last try. What Pacific Airlines mod? Yes, that's for the old war in the Pacific. Yeah, looks like. Said so, this game has such a big community and history. It's so much stuff was released for it. Yeah, that's basically the documentation for the mod, but one thing that is missing is simply what is this mod and what are the changes. I think that's one of the most doc important documents that should be here, in here, or on the front page or whatever. This looks like already in-depth stuff. Yeah, whatever. Perhaps find it out for yourself. it's a realism mod, and there's another one. It's, for me, it's a bit hard to tell the differences. It looks like this LRS mod, it does a lot to the mechanics. As you can see, the documentation, it looks like everything is modified. So perhaps this is the going for realism. And the people working behind it, they are pros, so they know a lot about this stuff in this game. And like I said, looks like even some features of this mod got integrated into Admiral's Edition. So yeah, a lot of, and it's still under current development. Just would wish, I know some people might follow this mod for years or even decades, but for a new guy, it's simply hard to get an idea what it is. Sure, a complete changelog would be too much, but simply a condensed form of what this mod does in general. So I think if somebody's working on such a project, it would also be great if he would see that new people are also interested in it. But it's hard for us to see what this is about. Yeah, I will do it off stream. However, I will now do, like I said, I don't want to play this on the stream. I think it's because I would play it in a laid back fashion. I won't go for this micromanaging 4 or 5 hours or whatever, even 1 hour. I will, and if you might be similar to me, you can play this game and you don't need, you know, if you go into the game and you don't understand a lot of what is going on, you don't need to set every base to whatever, especially when you play an historical scenario against the AI. A lot of people simply approach a game, they did stuff like in a sandbox, but there are orders in the game and stuff also works without you modifying it. Not to the most efficient way, of course, but the world keeps rotating without you doing something. So if you say, yeah, I'm interested into it, but this complete micromanaging, I don't understand it, or managing 1,000 bases and upgrade plans, sure, understanding this is helpful, but even without understanding it or engaging too deep into it, I think you can play and enjoy this game. I did some experiments where I played and I took a look at most of my bases, and they had some production set. I was thinking, okay, why not run it? Yeah, run it. And if problems arise, we will find a fix. And sure, there will be problems, you know. Japan, for example, has an oil shortage and whatever. And so you want to set some things so in order to lessen it. But doesn't mean if you don't change it that the game will, I don't know, explode or something. So if you check it out, and I think you can manage reasonable round times even for the first rounds without investing, I don't know, 10 hours into the first round. Okay, that's it. I will now continue with decisive campaigns. I will do a decisive campaigns playthrough.